Good morning, all of you. So I am here to present our research on use of ozonation for degradation of glyphosate in potable water of Ckdu prevalent areas. So this is the content of my presentation. Ckdu, or chronic kidney disease of unknown etiology, is a major health issue in North Central province of Sri Lanka. In the past few decades, a huge number of Ckdu patients and a death toll of around 20,000 has been recorded. So the possible causes for Ckdu is identified as direct consumption of food contaminated with pollutants and toxins, direct ingestion of agrochemicals due to careless handling, and prolonged exposure to toxins and pollutants from drinking water. Among these three possible causes, prolonged exposure of toxins of agrochemicals to into drinking water is identified as the main possible cause behind Ckdu. In the Ckdu prevalent areas, around the past 2-3 decades, glyphosate is the mostly used agrochemical. So this is the chemical formula of glyphosate. It consists of carboxylic group, amino group, and a phosphine group. Glyphosate is commercially available as Roundup. According to recent studies, glyphosate is detected in water sources of Ckdu prevalent areas. And also, 3.5% of Ckdu patients have contained glyphosate residues in their urine samples more than the recommended value. Therefore, glyphosate is suspected as one of the triggering factors for Ckdu. So its imports and use is banned now, but however, in some Ckdu prevalent areas, there is still unauthorized application of glyphosate in their cultivation. So in this figure, it shows that when glyphosate is applied into the cultivations, it gets contaminated into the water sources. And also in these water sources, there are heavy metals such as arsenic and cadmium which are contaminated from the fertilizers. So glyphosate has the ability to capture and retain arsenic and other heavy metals, and they can glyphosate act as a carrier compound to deliver such toxins into the human body. Also, when glyphosate is present in hot water, it reacts with calcium and magnesium ions and form very stable compounds. Since water sources in Ckdu prevalent areas consist high hardness, glyphosate in the water sources of Ckdu prevalent areas is very persistent and very difficult to remove. In previously conducted animal studies, it is found that glyphosate can cause adverse effect on kidneys. In its commercial grade, in Roundup contains glyphosate and some surfactants. The major surfactant of Roundup is POEA, or polyethoxylated toluene, which is more toxic to cells than glyphosate alone. Purged into a contaminated water sample, ozone is very unstable glyphosate is identified as a triggering factor for Ckdu. So therefore, there should be a proper removal method for glyphosate. But when the presence of hardness and presence of surfactants, glyphosate become more persistent in water. Therefore, even though ozonation is recommended as an effective technique for removal of glyphosate, its efficiency in the presence of hardness and in the presence of surfactants is not reported in literature. So, the objective of our study is to investigate the effectiveness of ozonation and the effect of hardness and the effect of presence of surfactants on the removal efficiency of glyphosate degradation by ozonation. So, this is the methodology we have covered. We prepared water samples consisting hardness and without hardness. Now, set of water samples we added high purity glyphosate and the other set we added Roundup. So, this is the, our experimental setup. This is the ozone disinfector we use in our laboratory. It consists of ozone generating capacity of 200 milligrams per hour, and ozone is releasing through the probe into water samples, and from time to time water samples are collected, and the amount or the concentration of glyphosate and NPK present in water samples are measured from time to time. In water samples, in the absence of hardness, glyphosate and NPK was measured by GCM analysis, and in the presence of hardness, of the experiments. Here, the concentration of glyphosate is indicated with respect to time. In both of these graphs, there is a rapid degradation of glyphosate concentration within first 10 minutes of the reaction. So, there is a rapid degradation of glyphosate and Roundup, both glyphosate and Roundup, within the first 10 minutes. This could be due to the reaction. This could be direct oxidation by ozonation and indirect oxidation by hydroxyl radicals in water. So this ozone and hydroxyl radicals react with the amino group and produce AMPA. But in our samples, AMPA was not detected. This could be the generated AMPA again degraded into more simpler compounds and form inorganic phosphate. This complete degradation of glyphosate takes place by the high ozone concentration. Effect of hardness. We require the graph and the time taken to reduce the glyphosate concentration into the maximum contamination level. Water samples consist of hardness takes more time to degrade glyphosate. So, in hard water, there are calcium and magnesium ions. These can form very stable and persistent bonds with glyphosate. And also, when there are calcium and magnesium ions in water, these ions cause the interference to ozone molecules to directly contact with the glyphosate ions. This could be possible reasons for the slow degradation of glyphosate in the presence of hardness. And the Therefore, we can conclude that ozonation is a simple, affordable and promising technique that could be effectively and efficiently used to degrade glyphosate. So, these are the references for the study. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ms. Jayasekara, for the presentation. Similarly, 2 days ago there was this glyphosate TV something. Somebody was arguing that it's not a banned item. There is a lot of controversy in some of these things. So I am sure that you will have some questions. But it's establishment is the component that is affecting these areas. So it's open for questions.
So thank you for the presentation. I have two questions. One is, in the first conclusion, you mentioned that in the first 10 minutes, the degradation is high. So after that, what kind of degradation you observe after the 10 minutes? I think 10 minutes is because of ozone concentration is over. Because ozone is a unstable compound, till readily react with substances and finish. So that is why I assume that is why in the first 10 minutes, the degradation rate is high. So after that, what kind of degradation?
Thank you very much.